Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to get GitHub repositories using REST API and Vue JS. First of all, you can open my GitHub account. I have shared this link in the description below. And then you will see two folders over here, End and Start. Feel free to run this end folder if you want to see the end result of our site. Or if you want to follow along with me, then you can run this start folder. Let me open this start folder in my text editor. And inside this component folder, we got one custom component called repository.vue. We will be customizing this very soon. And this component is imported in our main app, which is app.vue. Then in main.js, we have imported Bulma CSS as we are using Bulma framework for UI. Now let's add the node module. So open your terminal and make sure you are inside this start folder. If you are, then you can run npm space install. Once it is installed, you can run the project using npm run serve. Now, if you press Ctrl and click on the link, your project will run in the browser. And currently, our design is pretty simple. We got hero section at the top and some static content at the bottom. Our goal is to get GitHub repositories using API, and while working on API, we need to know endpoint and the method. The method will be get as we are getting data from GitHub, but to know the endpoint, you can search GitHub API in new tab. You can then click on this link, which is its official website. Then click on REST API overview, resources in the REST API, and currently all requests are made using this URL api.github.com. To test the response, you can use a software called Postman, which looks something like this. This is not compulsory, but if you use it, it makes it easier for you to test. It is also available for free to download. Now, let's test them in Postman. So you can paste your URL over here and make sure your method is set to get over here. Once done, you can click on this send button. Now, we can see some response at the bottom over here. But out of those response, what exactly do we need? We need to get GitHub repositories from my GitHub account based on my username. So go back to your site again, click on reference, repositories, and since we are getting repositories from a username, click on list repositories for a user. Then you will get another endpoint over here. So you can copy and paste them in your Postman. Where it says username, you can replace it with your own GitHub username. In my case, it is Bibeva. So I will write Bibeva. Once done, you can click on the send button again and you can wait for a response. We normally get response in JSON format, and here we can see all the information based on my GitHub repositories. Now we can choose which data to show in our site. So let's get back to our text editor. While working on data in Vue.js, we need to add Axios. So you can stop this by pressing Ctrl+C. And to install Axios, you can use npm install Axios. Once it is installed, you can run the project again using npm run serve. And then you can open repository.vue and import Axios from Axios. Just after this repository, let's add a data function which will return repos. I will set them to null for the time being. After that, let's create a created hook and a function. Then for Axios, we have to use axios.get. Now we need the endpoint, so you can copy from this Postman and paste it inside over here. Then response arrow function, this dot repos equals response dot data. Seems like it is ready now, and this repo should now get data from this endpoint. Now let's use for loop and interpolation to show the data. But first, let me remove these two table rows. And over here, I will use v4 repo in repos. Then the key will be repo.id. Now we need to show the ID. So over here, I can remove it and use double curly braces, and it will be repo dot, you can check in the Postman, its ID. So you can copy and paste over here. Likewise, the second thing we need is the name. So again, you can go to Postman and you can copy this name. Then we need the URL. So it will be repo dot HTML underscore URL. Then for language, it will be language. Finally, we need this login, so it will be repo dot login. But since login is inside owner, we have to first copy the owner. And then we have to use the login. Now you can check your site. You can refresh it. And you should see all these dynamic GitHub repositories. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.